You have such a great group of young actors. Talk about why you chose these guys.
Well, the simple answer would just be say each one of them was so special and was able to do any given of the roles, of the seven roles, so perfectly and wonderfully, and then to bring much of themselves that was even newer and fresher to it. So that's one of the ways I work with actors. I take everything I can find in myself and put it on the page, and then I say, whatever you have in yourself and bring that to me too. So these were kids that had that kind of depth and ability to be young, but also be really intelligent and deep. So it made for a very interesting, complex cast.
And talk about shooting this in 3D. What did that afford to you?
Well, that actually isn't the way it worked. We shot in 2D and never had 3D in mind. And then in post-production, the studio came to us and said, "We're interested in releasing this in 3D, and we want you to explore that and see whether you can work with it in a way that would make you feel totally comfortable." So I did a lot of research and a lot of soul searching, and came to the realization, mostly by watching films that were recently done in 3D, that you could manipulate space and kind of the feel of the image without having an axe fly out of the screen and hit the audience in the head, in a way that was really interesting, and also getting a sense that this is what's coming. Whether you think it's good or bad or whatever, it is coming. 3D is moving into theaters. The whole infrastructure is moving in a big way, and it's not going to go away. It's not like, oh, let's make a 3D movie like they did in the 50s. This is totally different. All this was done totally post-production, all by computer. It gives you a lot of ability to manipulate the sort of psychic space of that the audience is in, and you can do it subtly. You don't have to have big things popping out. So, for instance, Abel, who has these multiple personalities, and there's a key scene where he kind of loses his mind, or all these characters come out when he's looking in a mirror. You can take what you see in that mirror and take the background of each individual place of iteration of him, if you will, back farther and farther, where the audience just gets this feeling like, whoa. But they don't know what really was going on. But what you're doing is using the ability of 3D to move the spatial distances back and forth quite easily. So it just gave me more tools, really.
So, what kind of experience can audiences expect watching My Soul to Take?
Well, I think an audience watching My Soul Take is going to see a genre film unlike anything they've seen before. I think that can be honestly said. It's really much more, I think, well-rounded, and that sounds smug. It goes into things that mostly genre films don't go in. It goes into family and family's history. It goes into coming of age in a very, sometimes very tender way and sometimes very funny way. And it's sort of a puzzle. It's a puzzle that is revealed in the course of the film. So they're going to see something that approaches them and envelops them on many different levels, in a way that they'll be laughing one minute and screaming the next and trying to figure out things as it goes on all the way through.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Okay.